Dear students, today class will start at the unit number 1, distribution. We are discussing the F tests for the variance. A given problem will be given. A group of 10 rats fed on diet A, another group of 8 rats fed on diet B, according to the following increase in weight, diet A and diet B. So, given data will be there now. Diet A will be totally here. 10 data will be given, and then diet B will be a totally 8 data will be given. Asking the problem, find if the variance are significantly different. The F test, when we can use F test, means difference about the variance, significant difference about the variance, we can use only for the F test. You're directly asking the significant difference for the variances. So, going to the problem, entering solution. So, given N1 will be number of data in diet A, and N2 will be number of data in diet B. So, N2 will be 8. So, sample 1 and sample 2 just form the data. X1, this is the diet A, and then X1 square will be corresponding data will be taking the square, then normal value the total, then square value total. Then, similarly, here sample 2, here X2 data, and also X2 square value will be there now. So, correspondingly, X2 value will be total, and then X2 square total. Then, you should find out the X1 bar, it's a mean of the sample 1. So, this is X1 bar, summation of X1 divided by total number of data will be 10. So, here, finally asking the 6.4 will be answer. Similarly, X2 mean sample for the second data, summation of X2 divided by number of data will be 8. So, substitute got the 5, 10. This is a S1 square, this is a variance of the sample 1. So, summation of X1 square by N1 minus mean X1 bar the whole square. Substitute the value, you got the value will be 10.24. Then, you should find out the X2 square. So, S2 square is a summation of X2 square divided by N2. N2 data will be number of data 8. Substitute minus mean for the sample 2. So, X2 bar whole square substitute, you got the 10.25. Then finally, we should find out the capital S1 square and then capital S2 square. So before that, we should find out the small S1 square and the small S2 square. Then finally, we should find out the capital S1 square and the capital S2 square. This is a variance. So here, N1 S1 square divided by N1 minus 1. The degrees of freedom for the sample 1. So substitute N1. So S1 square value will be found out now. Before, the value will be 10.24. Just substitute here. In got the capital S1 square value will be 11.37. then S2 square, this will be formula will be similarly N2 S2 square divided by N2 minus 1, degrees of freedom for the diet B. This is sample 2. The substitute here, degrees of freedom is N minus 1. So here N2 minus 1 got the 7, value will be 11.71. so compare the variance. So, capital S1 square and capital S2 square, which is the highest variance. So, second one will be highest variance. So, capital S2 square will be highest variance, 11.71. S1 square value will be 11.37. So, here highest value will be 11.71. So, this is a variance for the highest, S2 square will be highest. So, here parameter will be, parameter of interest will be taking the sigma 1 square and the sigma 2 square. The sample variances. So when you enter the step 1 will be H0 will be null hypothesis, sigma 1 square and sigma square will be equal. So therefore the difference of variance is not significant. So H1 will be alternate hypothesis, so just take it opposite to the null hypothesis. Here sigma 1 square not equal to sigma 2 square. Then step 3 will be degrees of freedom at 5% level of significance. So here degrees of freedom will be sample 1 will be N1 minus 1. So here N minus 1 will be 9. Then degrees of freedom will be V2. Here N2 minus 1, here will be 7. So step 4 will be table value of capital F test. Can compare the from the table you provide in your examination hall and check the value. So here I am taking the degrees of freedom will be, so here degrees of freedom will be V1 will be 9, degrees of freedom will be 2 will be 7. So how should calculate the degrees of freedom? No, and from the table value. So here go to the step 5, statistic will be, so which is the highest variance, sample variance. So S2 square will be highest. So you put in which is the highest value, put in the numerator, and the lowest value put in the denominator. Just substitute, got the value will be 1.029. This is a calculated value for the F test, 1.029. Then step 6, conclusion. For the calculated value for F test and a table value for the F test. So here table value will be 3.29, but the calculated value will be 1.029. So here we accept the H naught, because here table value will be highest comparatively calculated value. So automatically here H naught will be accept. So we accept H naught at the 5% of the significance. So finally we conclude the solution. We conclude the two samples have come from the population with equal variance, because H naught will be accepted. So both the variance will be equal. Thank you.